Creators, hope you like that short video. So, I know you guys are tired of chasing free credits, unreliable AI tools, and short-term hacks. Guys, I'm not gonna fool around saying unlimited image, unlimited video generation promises. Instead, I'm here to guide you how to generate and high-quality, useful AI images and videos that will work long-term without relying on any free credits or beginner tricks. Many newcomers in the AI world fall into this trap of chasing free trials and gimmicks. Even me too. They hop from one tool to another looking for unlimited generations, but ultimately will waste time without mastering how to create an AI-generated content that truly stands out. If you wanted to produce an AI-generated images and videos that matter, here's what you need to focus on. Don't worry, I'm not going to take you deep into this technical. Instead of relying on free credits, invest time in understanding the best AI platform for image and video generation. I'm going to keep it very simple, guys. In the world of AI image generations, Google ImageFX emerged as a powerhouse, setting a new standard in the realism and creativity. With a cutting-edge algorithm, it delivers an hyper-realistic image and seamless textures that make AI-generated visuals almost indistinguishable from the real photograph. Whether it's in artistic compositions or a lifelike portrait, ImageFX excels in producing the stunning high-quality visuals. On the other hand, Kling attempts to compete but falls short in the realism and the refinement. I love Kling on the video generations, but not on the image generation. While it can generate the images, they often lack on the fineness and depth that Google ImageFX effortlessly achieves. Kling's output sometimes appear artificial, with the inconsistency in the texture and the lighting that makes them feel less immersive. For those who are seeking a breathtaking true-to-life AI-generated image, I would say Google ImageFX stands out as a superior choice, pushing the boundaries of what's possible in the digital creativity. I know this Google ImageFX is not available for everyone. Currently, it's free, and my all-time favorite on AI image generation is always ImageFX. Even if it comes with a subscription in the future, I will go with ImageFX because none of them produce such a good results. Trust me, guys, you might have seen my all trailer videos that all comes from ImageFX. This is very important. You know, people started ignoring AI video contents because they are bored of these AI images. They went to the next step of seeing hyper-realistic real AI images. Means a human should look like the same human. It should not be shiny. It should not be overly processed like an 8K, 16K fantasy. No. So, the image generators are struggling to meet that level now. Google ImageFX is already on that mark now. If you wanted to keep your work to stay out of everything and look so real to the world, you should go for ImageFX. Again, I'm not sponsoring or promoting this product. It's my honest suggestions to my creators. I know you guys are puzzled now. Let's do the real test on this and you will know what I'm really talking about. Also, you can comment if you find a better image generations giving a similar kind of output like this, like an hyper-realistic real image and the prompt that you use. You can put that on the comment. Okay, let's start with the Kling now. In the Kling, on the prompt, I'm gonna put a 35-year-old Indian woman, whatever, and I'm gonna pick the aspect ratio as 16:9, and we'll have a generating count as 1 now. So with this, I'm gonna submit it for Kling, generate, and I can just take the same prompt and go back to the ImageFX, and I can put the same prompt here. It's the same prompt. Click on create, it's the same landscape, the 16:9 aspect ratio, and we'll see the output. So in the Kling, you can see this output. It is good, so without comparing with the ImageFX. So let's see what is there on the ImageFX. Here you can see the differences between Kling AI and the ImageFX. Honestly, the ImageFX has a very good like a jungle, a deep forest nature, and she got a hacks in it. But here, I don't see an hacks in Kling AI. In the ImageFX, you can see clearly a woman holding an hacks in her hand. But in the Kling AI, do you see that? No, it's not there. So it's more accurate and it's more natural. And here, it's a little bit artistic, I would say. So that's the difference between ImageFX and Kling AI. Okay, let's do another round of test. Now, we'll go with a different prompt. A 7 feet tall bull in an arena depicting the scene of a Jallikattu event in southern India. I'm not going to change any other parameters. Let's leave it as is and hit generate. And now let's copy the same prompt and we'll put it in the ImageFX and we'll see. Okay, we got the Kling output here. Let's get the ImageFX output and then we'll start comparing them. Here we go. We got both of them now. Guys, what do you think? If you've been this far, please drop your comments and mention which image generation tool is accurate and realistic. For me, it's still ImageFX. I'll tell you why. Did you see the bull's arm in the Kling AI? It's not a South Indian type. And look at the crowd. Do you feel it's from the southern part of India? I don't think so. Look at the ImageFX, the bull's arm and the crowd, what they are wearing. That gives you more accurate on the image details. So quality and accuracy, I would still say it's ImageFX. Okay, let's do one more round of testing. A pack of coyotes in the Arizona desert roaming around. And let's see the results. Yes, as usual, ImageFX, more natural. You can see the desert scene. It's like a real picture taken by a wildlife photographer. And here is a Kling AI. More artistic painting with the mountains, desert, and the coyotes looks like more artistic and not real. That's the difference. Okay, let's test some fantasy picture, how it generates. An Iron Man walking down the San Francisco busy street. And here's the result. Kling AI, I don't feel that Iron Man is walking down the SFO street because the background is completely blurred. So there's no point here. ImageFX, I can see the SFO bridge and the SFO cable car around the street. So I can feel that Iron Man is really walking down the SFO street. So again, I would say ImageFX gives you a high quality and accurate results for your prompt. Now, one more. An Iron Man fighting with a monster predator deep in the forest in a low blue light. Camera angle is from the low angle. And here's the result. I added a word called fighting in the prompt, but I don't see an Iron Man is fighting here in the Kling AI. He is just looking at the predator. Also, I'm not looking for a school kind of predator. I mean the real predator from the movie. You guys know what I mean. And look at the ImageFX. First of all, I got the predator, what I want in the picture, and Iron Man is fighting with it. At least here they both are touching and some action is here. In Kling AI, I don't see any action there. I'm not saying Kling AI image generation is not good. It is good on its own way. I'll tell you how. ImageFX, you cannot generate a celebrity images. In Kling AI, you can do that. Check this out. Tom Cruise walking down the Hollywood street. A Hollywood star, a Tom Cruise, he is more accurate and I can make some wild content with it. ImageFX, it is restricted. You cannot generate any celebrity images here. One more, it's a Taylor Swift. And in Kling AI, you will get the results, but not in ImageFX. So for hyper-realistic images, the first position goes to ImageFX. And the second position goes to Kling AI, which supports the celebrity image generation, and I like that most here. Now, getting into the videos. In AI video tools, Kling AI allows you to transform a static AI image into a dynamic videos. Currently, Google Veo 2 is not available. So my next best video generation tool is Kling AI. I'll explain on my next video how best is this and how you can create a stunning videos and make it viral. If you wanted to generate an AI content without limits, stop chasing these free trials and start learning how to use the AI tool efficiently and use the reliable and quality AI applications for your image and video generation. I'm not here to sell your dreams of unlimited free AI generations. I'm here to guide you how to create an AI images and videos that are actually valuable. When you focus on quality over quantity, you will never have to worry about this kind of limitations and free stuffs again. Let's start creating AI contents and that lasts forever. Let's go.